guys, as you know, we're here at Next Gen Summit, and I've actually come across Stacey Ferreira. She was actually on stage just now, gave a beautiful talk. Such a pleasure to meet you, Stacey.
Great to meet you.
I know you're from San Fran, so you've made the trek out here, well, the trek, if you will, to New York. I'm really fascinated about your startup, if you will, called Forge. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, so Forge, we're building an on-demand labor model that allows people to work at multiple retail outlets and restaurant outlets across America with one app for all their on-demand scheduling.
OMG, this is an OMG moment, because I know when I was, you know, well, a teenager or a young adult, and I was like working in like, you know, like Just Jeans or, you know, Macy's or whatever it was, and you had to report to your manager, and it was really a headache with the scheduling. So you make it super easy to like work multiple locations at different times.
Yeah.
Wow, how did this come about? Were you working multiple jobs and you found it really hard to juggle? Like, how did you get into this?
Yeah, so actually one of my best friends graduated from college and then started working in retail and started telling me about all the issues that she had with scheduling. She was like, you know, my manager gives me my hours once a week and they're capping hours now because they don't want to pay for full-time health benefits. So I kind of put two and two together and said, if we can allow people to work on demand, pick their own hours, get approved to work at multiple locations, then people can earn a living wage working more hours at more places.
So smart, so smart. It's definitely the future. So tell me, how long have you guys been launched? Are you live? Like, what's the rollout?
Yeah, so we're actually getting ready to launch later this month.
Right.
So we're launching first in Salt Lake City, Utah, as the first location.
We've been why Salt Lake, can I ask?
Yeah, so we have four brands out in Salt Lake City that they've
agreed
to come on board and be
the guinea pigs
for this. So we're really excited to be doing our launch in just a few days.
Fantastic. Seriously, like, there's a lot of startups, obviously, you know, everyone's kind of got an idea or a concept, and I heard yours, and I just thought, hallelujah, like, there's something that's actually going to better the lives of people, and also be beneficial for brands, right, because they can cross-pollinate, they can, you know, utilize different talent they wouldn't usually have access to, so it's like a win-win situation. Tell me, as a founder, and I'm going to bring this up because you are today the third female I've spoken to, probably spoken to about 30 men. At Parley Me, we're all about bridging the gap between men and women. So I just want to ask you how you found it being a female entrepreneur and now founder, being female.
Yeah, so it's been great. I think there are a lot of things that you can use as a female to your advantage, right?
Yeah.
Certainly a lot of different press opportunities. The panel that I was just on was titled Girl Power.
Right.
So I think
right.
There's a lot of opportunities that come by being female.
There is. And it's definitely one of those areas that over time it's getting better and better, but we've got to really empower each other, and it's great that they have panels like that. Is this your first Next Gen Summit?
I was actually here last year too, so this is the second time.
Oh, you're a Next Gen veteran. No, not really. So did you have this concept last year, or when did it come about?
No, so I've been working on this for just about 7 months now, so
wow.
This is a new concept that I've been working on.
Oh, is this your first startup? Forgive me, I haven't done my research. Stacey, please forgive me. Is this your first, second?
It's actually my second.
Oh,
so
wow.
I started an internet security company with my brother back in 2011 that I sold when I was 20 years old to Reputation.com in 2013.
Wow, you are definitely killing the game. I love it. So I have a couple of questions for you. Is there something in the startup, like, you know, starting your own startup that you found super challenging? Mm-hmm. And is there something that you thought would be super challenging, but it was actually easier than you thought?
Yeah, so I think the most challenging thing, like most founders will tell you, has been hiring. So
yeah.
Finding the right talent, the best talent, to kind of
right.
fit the needs of the company as it's growing and through every stage.
Yes.
So that's been one of the biggest challenges.
Right, absolutely. Like co-founders and your CTOs and your CMOs and COOs, the list goes on. You've got to make sure you have that, you know, buttoned down. And is there something that was like, you thought, oh, this is going to be the biggest hurdle to get through, or roadblock, and you're like, actually, that's actually okay. Like,
yeah, I was going to say. So for us, our business plays a lot into labor law, right? Since
right.
we're staffing people and having people work in these kind of
right.
weird schedules.
Yes.
But that's been something that initially I thought would be a huge hurdle, and it hasn't been so tough so far.
Fantastic. Heard it here first. People not as rigorous as you'd think. So I have two final questions that are equally as important, though. Is there an entrepreneur that you look up to and you're like, wow, that's the pinnacle for me?
Oh, boy.
It can be anyone.
This is a really tough question.
I know. There's a few floating around today, but they're all under 30, so they don't count. No, I'm just joking. They totally count.
Oh, man. I'm not sure necessarily about entrepreneur, but I think I really look up to... It's hard because if I name names, no one would probably know.
You can say your dad. It's okay. Some people have.
My dad is great. So my dad, I've learned a lot about enterprise sales from my dad, and we do have a lot of enterprise sales with the business that we're doing into these retailers. So he definitely is a role model.
See, there you go. There you go. And the final question, roulette, blackjack, or poker?
Oh, man. Oh, that's a really hard question, too. I really like poker, though.
Ah, she sees strategic. Poker face. I like it. I like it. Look, absolute honor to meet you, Stacey. I'll put a link to your site when it launches in about a month or so.
Perfect.
Is it forge.com?
Joinforge.com.
Joinforge.com. The future of the market, the workers' marketplace, really, isn't it? I love it. Such a great concept. Such a pleasure to meet you. Enjoy the conference. And check it out, guys. Joinforge.com. Hi guys, as you know, we're here at the Next Gen Summit, and I'm here and I actually met some really fascinating guys, Max Schoenfeld, I hope I'm pronouncing that right, and Jacob Goodman. It's such a pleasure to meet you guys. I know it's only like, well, it's about noon now. Are you enjoying the conference? Like, what are some highlights so far, other than me? You don't have to say me.
Yeah, I think it's been a try hold.
Oh yeah, a hold.
I think it's been great so far. It really, you know, there are a lot of people out there that pride themselves on building communities, you know, and really you know, bring together interesting groups of people. But Justin and Dylan, they don't just talk about it, they've actually done it. And I think the talent here and the level of kind of connection that they foster is really, it's amazing. This is by far the best event like this I've ever been to.
Awesome, there you go. Massive plug for you guys, Next Gen. Cue the music. No. Okay, are you? No, you tell the truth. No, I'm just joking. It is a really good conference, and I'm meeting the likes of you guys, and there's some fascinating speakers here. Medium age, everyone's under 30, so that's fine. Everyone's had their exits and they're 19. I'm not bitter at all, no, I'm just joking. So guys, so tell me, this is your, I'm interviewing you for College Shoppers, and you just told me 2 seconds ago it's your second business together. So you guys are partners in life, it seems. Like, you're on the, yeah.
I'm gonna move in with him.
So to that point, were you friends first before you started your first business together? How did it come about?
Well, not really. We're in the same fraternity at school, and we actually bought a business together, and then we ran it, we grew it, actually doubled it over 3 years, and then we sold it when we were 22.
Together. Yeah, we weren't done.
Well, it's never quite enough when you're an entrepreneur. So tell me a little bit about College Truckers. What is it exactly?
Yeah, sure. So essentially the product is, it's a full service storage and shipping company for college students. So that's the product, but it's not, to be honest, the product that I love so much about it. What I love about this company is kind of the way we operate. And the way we operate is basically, on each campus that we open up, we go out and we recruit a team of young entrepreneurs. Students at that campus, generally freshmen or sophomores, so 18 or 19 year old kids, and we actually empowered them to essentially start our essentially a franchise of our business on their campus. So we provide the
elevated door. Don't worry about that.
Oh, good New York background. We provide the all of the funding, the financing. We provide basically the business plan, the marketing plan, you know, things like that. Access to our website, to our systems, and then we say, okay, we're going to basically hand you this business in a box. You guys take it, run with it, put your name on it, and make it yours.
Fantastic! I love that. And and how do you recruit these people? Like, is there a selection process? Obviously, they've got to embody what you guys are about. So how's that going?
The idea is that universities do a terrible job fostering entrepreneurship, so let's do it ourselves. But everything comes down to the student. The entire secret of the business.
Really?
So it took 5 months for each student of screening. We screened each one for about 5 months.
Wow. And when you say screening, you're following them around Big Brother style? Like, that sounds intense. I'm joking. How do you get your resources? Is it like a Q&A in person? Do they have to submit their credentials? Like, if they're watching now, how do they get involved?
Yeah, well, basically he sends them, Max is our CEO, and he sends them a very scary packet, basically saying, you're signing your life over to us, this is all you're going to do, you're going to be dripping sweat all the time.
No, guys, no. Well, the name College Truckers, but no.
There's a lot of labor.
There's a lot of labor, yeah. So tell me, what sort of labor?
Yeah, so they, you know, when it comes down to Operation Season, of course, when they're doing the move-outs and move-ins, you know, most of our schools are actually, at this point, the majority are in the South, and so it's always 95 degrees, you know, and it's always, you know, it really is, it's hard, it's backbreaking work. It's backbreaking work physically, mentally, and emotionally, and we tell them right up front that we're going to push you to your limits, and that we promise them, and I also think we succeed.
Yeah, absolutely, and look, if they can feel like they're getting a piece of the pie, so to speak, and they can be work their own hours, I guess, and kind of schedule when they can, I mean, it's the work of the future, so that's fascinating. So are you here, obviously, in North America, plans to go global, how long have you even been live?
Sure. Yeah, so we just wrapped up our second Operation Season. We've grown from our first year, we were on 2 campuses, this year we grew to 8. And so anyway, next year we're going to probably double that to 16, between 16 and 20. And yeah, as of now, it's just in the States. We thought about some Canadian universities, but you know, we're...
Those Canadians. I'm joking. No, we love the Canadians. So, okay, I have two last questions for both of you.
Okay.
First, yeah, don't worry. It's nothing too rigorous here. So if there's an entrepreneur that really inspires you or you just look up to in general in the world, who is it?
I
have a few.
Oh, you have to only pick one.
Yeah. Oh my God.
I know. So
can I please pick two? Are you going to let me pick two?
All right. Just
okay, because I have
you.
To say one Gucci
yeah.
thing.
Okay,
all right?
Okay.
So first I'll get the Gucci thing over. My father, so hopefully he sees this.
Yeah.
My family's been in the same business for 90 years, so.
Wow.
So my father, I think Richard Branson.
Yeah.
I love that he doesn't leave the company. I love that he builds a portfolio and then continue to stay active and just find great people to manage them.
Yeah.
As opposed to like having like a clean slate at the end.
Yeah, well, he doesn't really need to leave them, does he?
Yeah.
But no, I know what you're saying. He is. He's right up there for me as well, obviously.
Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome about your dad. Yeah, what's your dad's name?
His name is Mark Goodman.
Mark Goodman.
Yep,
very cool.
He's here today.
Is he? Oh, that's so cool. We'll have to get a photo of you guys together later.
Okay.
And for yours?
Yeah, so mine is, I think, as kind of a cliche answer, but it has to be Elon Musk. And the reason for that is I really think that he is one of the amazing minds of our generation, and frankly of any generation, and that he looks at things, big picture things, and he doesn't accept anything for the way it is. You know, he questions everything, and he really trusts himself to turn massive institutions and ingrained products on their heads, and he's never satisfied. And to me, that is the embodiment of an entrepreneur.
Absolutely, and he always seems to have the customer in mind and doing things for the better, improving things. So he's obviously up there for me as well. Final question: blackjack, poker, or roulette?
A roulette. I'm dangerous on the roulette table.
Craps.
Oh, okay. He thinks outside the box. I have a feeling you've got a few stories there. But look, no, such a pleasure to meet you guys. Enjoy the conference. There's lots going on. I really appreciate your time.
Thank you
so much. Cheers. Thank you.